with possibilities what it could be.
Yeah, also try different stuff. Like, what kind of helped is like smooth steering or not steering at all on the actual cruise control block.
Yeah.
Like, when you full steer on it, it's kind of shit because you drop speed, but it also wasn't always working.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't know. But yeah, it will be updated to a ring, which I also tested that now. It's more consistent than it only... the difference was, like, in between 5 kilometers an hour. Like, that's okay. Better than 22.
I actually think you want an action key 3 through the ring.
In theory.
Well, it's actually something I tested. Or try to test, but
yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, I could try to replicate that, but for keyboard players, it's kind of shit then, for example.
Oh, wait a minute.
What is this actually? Is it tech?
That's tech.
Tech. Yeah, Pok. Yeah, of it course I'm tech. Back for tech, and yesterday was dirt full speed.
Wait, that's...
I'm not surprised.
Wait, and this is kind of tough, actually.
Wait, do you know
the
map?
I saw this map on the stream. Or is it? Is it the map?
Would it look that tough in the overview? I look like normal.
I can go up, that I can say my rhyme again. Grenade is back, we will have tech.
Actually true. Good and true. It kind of looked like speed tech from the overview,
yeah,
but
okay,
it's
yeah.
Not. Wow.
Yeah, the map looked a lot...
Oh my god, that respawn! Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay, you never want to fail there. Noted.
You missed such a great cup of the day yesterday.
What was happening?
Yeah, sick map. Very close rounds overall. And Did not even work. Nothing worked. Nobody could trophies. Well, almost, I was the only player that got that made it into the night cup of the day. Because I 1 minute before the seating ended, I came onto a server, like the only one that was there. I started driving, I could have finished, of course. But like after 2 or 3 seconds of driving, I got heavy teleports and couldn't really get away there. And then at some point after 2 minutes, the server died.
Rip. That finish, though.
I would be the only one to finish.
That would be really funny. Seems like a good map. In the first few. Finish seems kinda monka.
Yeah.
I mean, I got it first try, but... Bear General looks like good map. Quite intuitive as well, I would say.
Yeah. I just have so many full speed parts.
Yo, I like that.
The whole middle is like before the last shift is super low full speed.
What do you want to do in the ending though? Do you want to go for no airtime or do you just want to jump maybe? The only question that I have. But if one shouldn't be an issue here. I hope. Yeah, but this one is... This is the kind of tech that I'm good at. I don't know, this is not like full tech. I don't even know why, I can't even describe what's different here, but... On this map I just feel comfortable.
GPS is at the time.
Yeah, I guess you just want to jump in the ending.
A little bit more fast paced, it's like not competitive tech.
Yeah, exactly.
You have like drawn out drifts, you have a lot of time for every single drift as well.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm like not no slight danger, not in no slight danger here.
GPS is a 38.7. I can recommend. Probably I will never beat that time.
0.33 now. Am I safe with the probably. I don't know. I think in the ending you just wanna jump, to be honest. Like, don't try to minimize airtime there. Just jump. There's one gear that you can get in flight 3.
dein platform works nice. I mean, yep. So far at least.
Oh, Mr. Resub. Oh, yo, Epiphany. 10 months. Thank you. Sorry, I missed it. Indeed.
Bank platform?
There's one platform slide here. Oh, no, two, but... Like, that's the fourth slide, banked. I think. After the small no-slide part.
Yeah, but what exactly does... What exactly works with it?
I mean, it just feels good.
The exit that I exactly end up where the speed is coming again.
I, as a non-tech player, understand that.
I did not understand how a turn works or doesn't work, but okay.
For non-tech Andes, it means you just can't take the line and feel comfortable.
I see. So the line is... It has an obvious line, basically.
Yeah, at least I would say so.
I guess you could also just call the turn easy.
Yeah. Found a risky finish.
What do you mean found?
Nah, just try something else.
I mean, that's super long. It's so weird. At least at least the finish is easier than it looks.
Yeah, true.
Because I was legit scared of that finish.
Same, but I never failed it so far. So I'm gonna probably in the knockout.
I am having trouble with the start though.
Be the most
not getting out of there. Rift. What now?
The third drift is for me the most difficult. The right hand.
Oh yeah, that one is important.
Because you can keep that gear, I assume, and yeah, I didn't do so yet. Don't find where I could start my drift.
I don't like the first drift. That's the only thing.
I say, I don't know. 13th now, 15th.
We have 8 minutes to spare.
Could be close.
Oh, I don't like the first.
I'm gonna watch the GPS now. The storage combination is kinda difficult.
Yeah, as I watched it, I have no problems with that.
Just wanna see how far inside he goes. I goes like middle in both slides, kind of. And then. Yeah, and he's keeping the keeping the upper gear is very important, I guess. Oh yeah, good map.
Yo.
Player from Team Halku on my server.
Yo.
That's a very old team.
That's very old indeed.
It's Asoziale Halku.
Oh. Yeah, a few of them I still see around.
Keeping the upper gear in that slide is very difficult. Oh, I kept it. Let's see how fast it is. Oh!
Oh.
Yeah, describes it quite well. I mean, I gained 0.2 only because of that. It's worth an O.
Just made interface on, I see. We still have 5 minutes and 55 seconds. I look at my position, 55th.
Okay, 08, that should be safe.
Okay.
my endings.
Why do I lose so much time?
Oh, I kept up again. Okay. Actual tech play.
And 16.
That's PB. Never mind. Couldn't make the last turn. Yo, thank you, Splite. Although I wasn't that consistent yesterday. That was enough.
Who cares about consistency when you win?
Yeah, I do. I'm probably the only one. Like, I still feel like I didn't drive that good yesterday. It was good, but there were still like quite some unnecessary mistakes.
I mean, you made more mistakes than
yeah, like on Vertigo it was dumb. And on the first map, it was also... I didn't really make a mistake, but I had like three small ones. Without them, I could have won there, theoretically.
Did you see how you got the multiplier?
Yeah.
I didn't understand it at all.
I mean, only Afi let me overtake, didn't he?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, he was second, but...
Yeah, and then... But I sniped Cole Jr., for example.
Yeah, but how? Like, how did you have more speed after that? It just didn't really make sense to me.
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, I didn't even recognize you till the finish line. Didn't even know that you are there.
I mean, there were like four players within each other. Or five.
Yeah,
at the end. But before it was like... Afi, it was Peck, I think, it was Gwen. You came a bit out of surprise, but the thing is, of course, that... that Afi led you through, it was extremely crucial, and I did not understand why Afi was doing that.
Yeah, I mean, he had 30 points.
Yeah.
And 30 x2 isn't that much. I mean, if I was him, I would have gone for it, but he just probably felt like fast enough to risk for a higher multiplier. I mean, he was fast, but there wasn't enough in the other rounds. That's just the risk you take when you do something like that. That's exactly why I'm not doing it. I hope you're proud of me, Marius.
Yeah.
Have you seen somebody denying... Yeah, Gwen. But only... Like, even he only barely got it. But so far, every single gamble didn't really work out in the end.
No.
He's the team GL, it's just a too high level. I mean, even Carl Jr. is mostly going for it in every round. But that he only got two multipliers. I mean, times two multipliers. That is the reason why he's still far behind in the season. Because you really need to have this one higher one, unless you score like Anadi.
I mean, Carl is not practicing this season, at least not that much.
Yeah, why would he though? It's understandable. How? I mean, just no motivation, you know, obviously. Since... You don't get rewarded for being better prepared or something, you know?
Not necessarily,
you just don't
yeah.
get rewarded for driving better.
I mean, for example, yesterday the best player was in theory was Mada. Which place did he get? He had 79 points after the first 6 laps.
Yeah.
After the first
this
4
laps. This is the very first time that the top player didn't get a top multiplier or didn't even get a multiplier at all. First time that this happened. Because in all the other steps, the one that was leading also got either a multiplier by 4 or even by 5 in every single step. That's why we always had 6 scores. But yesterday was the first time that the winning score was actually pretty low.
Yeah.
Yeah.
True. What was it, like 220 by Binks?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, not that high. We often had like at least 1-300. Maybe even 400.
I found it funny how a worker got a multiplier and still was last. Imagine getting a multiplier and still end up in last.
I mean, how many points did you have? 8?
Yeah.
Yeah. Shit, I could have actually just won.
Minus 0.2 is still. It was smart for him though, not going for a higher higher multiplier. People were talking about him, why is he not going for like at least X5 or something like that, but it was smart that he didn't take that he just took the one he could. Because if you think about it, like even times 8 times 5 is just shit anyway. Like even that is just not making a difference.
Yeah,
and
like
instead 40. Of risking it getting something that you might not get, since it's not worth the points anyway. You at least somebody else the quality. Yeah, you at least take for sure somebody else's point off, you know.
Yeah, that is what he definitely succeeded in. Of course, exactly. People now say, shouldn't he try to take uppers the times 5 away? But it
the risk is
who you have behind.
You just take the multiplayer you get there, so you have a confirmed one multiplayer less for the others. Your opponent is not the one getting the times 5. Your opponent. Toy in any way, just by default already.
Oh.
Yeah, it's difficult, you know, like, because, you need a couple of top 8 finishers on the maps.
I mean, theoretically, if you always are only good on 6 lepers, you can still get top 8 without 6 lepers, like, if you get...
I pulled a Granati.
Like, if you get, like, 80 points per step, if you're, like, just imagine you're really good at 6 lepers, but on 2 lepers you just don't get it at all. If you get,
you're
like...
really good, yes.
If you get, like, 80 points each step, then you will end up on, like, 640. That could be enough, should be enough. Roughly?
Yeah, definitely.
But yeah,
if you're, like, just mediocre but still good. Like if you're just maybe like third or fourth best in 6 lepers overall, I think that alone is not enough.
No. I mean, I think I still have like the highest 6 leper points. And how many points do I have on average? Like 55, 6, or 60 maybe?
Could be around that, yeah.
Oh, there was this one.
Yeah, the worst I had was 50. I think.
About you, Granati, in the virtual stream, said like that you only missed up on the top 8 very few times, and it was on that map with the reactor boost ending, the snipe. Oh, I just imagined. How did you know that you were 7th before? Like if you were a camera 1 player, you would know you are 7th, and then you. I don't know what happened at the end for you.
I had a bad entry, and then I oversteered in the flight. It was really unfortunate. But on that map, like, that's by far my worst map so far in the season. And, I mean, my ice points weren't even good. Just my reactor points are usually actually that good. So yeah, with better ice points next week and without the choke, I can easily get top 8 in Fury.
But yeah, that's such a small time loss that costs you the 3 places. Crazy.
Yeah. It cost me like 12 or 30 points. It's so crazy. But yeah, like, I always get 3 out of 4 top 8s. Like, in the last 3 steps it was like that. In step 2 I had 2 out of 4, but therefore in step 1 I had 4 out of 4. So on average I exactly have 3 out of 4. And whenever I didn't get top 8, it was not because I was... It mainly was because I had a stupid mistake. Only on launch, but I was just a bit too slow.
In the warm-up, by the way, I PB'd and I drove a 0.89.
Wait, actually? 38.89?
Yeah, actually a pretty good time, yeah.
That's really fast.
0.89.
No, that was well.
And it was before I joined the server with a warm-up, so it counts.
Yeah, of course.
I'm not sure if that's safe top 100, though. It will be so close. The end.
There are 8 steps, so 3 more.
Neotertia said... Regarding Carl, don't you still need the points to qualifying for the World Championship?
Ah, yeah, true. Wait, yeah, top 8? Wait, no, I don't know how they make it this year. Because last year, it was like a combination of the performance in fall 2020 and in winter 2020. So I don't know if it will be combined again. That would, of course, be shit for me, for example. I have actually no idea how they will do that. The thing is, if I would play the open qualifier for the World Cup, I would probably not qualify, to be honest.
Probably.
I mean, it depends on what maps they pick, but... Like, on the 2-lapper format or 1-lapper or what we play in World Cup, like... That's just bad for me.
It would be very difficult, let's put it that way.
Like, many people that I would... That I'm beating right now in the league on the 6-lappers, they would just crush me there. And also, like... quite a few challenger players, like Mayim, for example, or Evon. They would probably beat me there in general.
Yeah.
Or Otek.
I mean, it's not a big surprise, though. I mean, your consistency is your biggest weapon.
Yeah, I mean, but they also have fast maps. Like, if they pick maps like Vertigo, for example, for the World Cup, then...
Which map is that, actually? I don't know the pipe names.
Maps.
Yeah, well, okay. It's all about steering there, though.
Yeah, but I mean, for example, on the Edge, for example, which is a pace map, I actually was on WR quite a few times there. So I kind of improved on maps like that, but yeah, I don't know. It depends.
I mean, you're not slow.
You know, not fast enough.
your strength, it's just not your strength, you know?
Yeah.
Like if you look at you and how your playstyle, your consistency is obviously what stands out.
No.
If you would be consistent but slow, then you would basically not be in GMGL either.
But I mean, I still got 4 out of 5 multipliers so far, so it's still like. I am improving on it, but I need to improve even more if I wanna have a chance at like World Cup, for example.
Yeah.
Peter, thank you for the prime sub. Fabian also had a good idea, but I can't tell you now as he started.
Yeah, the thing is, like, usually. Usually my PBs aren't just not that good, but I can drive my PBs like consistently. But if I would improve my PBs, I would be giga strong. Easy equation.
Really don't know how to approach this turn.
It's especially scary because you can fly out in the ending.
Yeah. And this end is also difficult.
Yeah, the last slide is not easy.
Papian wrote, a simple change to the multiplier format would make it so much more skill-based. Win to increase your multiplier by 1. If you stop there, you take your multiplier, or you need to win again to get another plus 1. Once you won a round, you either have to keep winning to increase multiplier, or you get knocked out with a times 1 default multiplier.
I don't think you understood that correctly, because if I understood it correctly, then literally nobody would ever go for a second.
Yeah, I also...
Like, you win the first round, you instantly go out, because you're never ever gonna be able to win the second round as well.
Yep, unlikely.
I mean, I think that's not how he means it, probably, because that doesn't really make sense. I mean, the argument right now is that it's impossible to say, yeah, I can win a round. It's like, I mean, people have having issues in general winning a round in future.
Yeah, in my opinion, just lowering the multipliers would make it a lot better. Like, when the highest multiplier would be 2x, and then it would be like
1.25.
Yeah, but that would be the most already.
Yeah.
But 5x is just too much. Like, I don't think the multiplier should allow you to turn a mediocre step into, like, a very good one. Like, you should... Yeah. If you get 40 points after... Like, the way... Bing's actually a good example. Like, he had solid 6-lappers, like, 45 points. That's, like, in the midfield. But he shouldn't be able to win the step just because he gets a good multiplier, if you ask me.
Yeah, same.
Extremely, it's very extreme in that challenge or thingy.
Yeah.
Someone like Energize wins the step then, just because he's the one with the times 5.
I mean, in the challenger it's still a bit different because the skill gap is a bit bigger. I mean, you saw it with Otak, for example. Like, he can risk for the higher multiplier. In TMGL it just wouldn't work like that.
I know, that's a huge
unless
difference.
It's like when at full practice.
But because there is this huge difference, and because Mayim and Otak are usually having more points and are above everyone else, it's crazy that the others can win the step just because they get times 5.
No.
No, exactly. Yo, Chaos Camper, thanks for the resub.
Like, nobody is that consistent, even Granadi, it just doesn't work. Like, Trackmania is not... It doesn't work like that, driving Trackmania, especially on these kind of maps, you know? You can't just say, yeah, I'm the best and I definitely is, am gonna win like this round.
I mean, Gwen last step made that quite nicely. But he was also on another level on that map, like his CP times.
No. Gwen also not. You could see Gwen going for X3 already as well, and I don't think you could see that with Gwen. Yes, it worked out for him, but I don't think it was like that impressive.
That's the,
I mean, he did 219.45. That was like kind of almost WR.
but then he also struggled a bit. I mean, it's hard to say from what point exactly he tried to get the point.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Try to get something then, because that's difficult. But it didn't, like, when I spectated, I wasn't like, at some point, like, going towards X4 and X5, I was like, Ben might regret this right now. Like, that's how I felt.
Yeah, possible.
I didn't feel confident in him making it. Maybe he had the confidence. I don't know. It did, but that's not how it came across me watching.
No, that's just something that Gwen knows.
Yeah. Well, yes. I mean, it's super hard to say, right? Did he just have a slow round now, or did he like not even did you not try to win it?
Yeah, exactly.
You know, that's basically the thing you can't really see.
Yeah. True. Wait, is it not working, Iridium? It should be. Oh, can somebody sub to test it? Nah, Kappa.
Nice one.
Yeah.
No, the thing is, it actually is quite a good format. But considering, like, just getting top 8, you know, like, that's totally fair. Like, you can't really, like, if you don't get top 8, then you don't deserve it, in my opinion. It's not that unfair that you can't really say that. But my problem with this format is right now that, even the positions within the top 8 are super important, because the prize money is super high for those already, you know? Like, no. if it would just be, get top 8 and then we are gonna, like, fight for the money, I would be cool with that. But considering the amount of money that's already in these top 8 positions, you know, that's what's striking me a bit.
You know, are you talking about? Sorry?
Hmm?
What money are you talking about? Yeah, but honestly, like, it's not about the money, right?
Portrait Mania players, it is.
Mine is,
For the Team JR players, it obviously is.
Yeah, but... I think that's also because the reason that for some people the motivation is just not as high, because it's not really worth going for the money to put in the hours.
I mean, I like the fact that you gain something from the group stage, because they are way more likely to win something than in the playoffs. Like, in the playoffs, I would probably get wrecked, to be fair. It's like gonna be the same as for the World Cup, what we earlier spoke about. Unless they pick good maps, I cannot do that much on two lappers against most of the players. Holy shit, that was risky. Yeah, oh, I did 39 flat.
But the fact that the distribution is basically 50-50 between group stage and playoffs is kind of weird.
Yeah, I mean, but playoffs is only like one day or two at most, and like the other thing is like being consistent over several weeks. I don't know.
Yeah, well, with the system being the way it is right now, no.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, okay.
Like if the system, I mean, two or three good, then yes, definitely.
I mean, imagine you have three extremely good weeks where you get like 400 points. That could be the win already.
Yeah.
But then you deserve it.
Yes, Jerkbird.
Then you definitely deserve it. But yeah. It's impossible. It's just the issue that Nadio is trying to make Trackmania something that's not the show. Just not what kind of game this is. It's not meant to be.
I mean, show is fine here and there, but I don't know if we need a show with the point system. Like, have some kind of special maps, okay. I don't know if the point system needs to be... I mean, it is exciting to watch, to be fair.
Lol, I'm 29th with plus 0.805. So I'm 3 places in front of 30 seconds, which is only 2 hundredths behind.
Yo, Jerkbird, thanks for prolonging the sub. Yeah, it's kind of rare, Minotaur, too. Ah, yeah, true.
But I have to say that even though we have this format in this point system, somehow it is actually pretty tight overall.
Yeah, it's super close. I was also surprised by that.
Because it's like everyone has just one really that good step, or Granati has a lot of decent steps, but others, like Bassa, one very good step, and they all end up at similar points now. So.
And I also think that it's not like everyone can still make it in the last step into playoffs, because some people are just too far behind already.
I think it's theoretically it's possible, but most people just won't do it, because, I mean, why should they exactly be really strong in the last step if they were bad before? The possibility is there, but Monka S Shorty, by the way.
I don't think it's gonna happen. A small touch, holy shit, at the end.
Yes, Minotaur will.
Oh.
Yeah, actually the rounds are quite close here. Like, we're barely speaking about the cup itself. It's quite tight.
Actually, it wasn't tight so much. Till now.
Just remember, like, top 50 top round where we had, like... But also not that big gaps. Okay. Hit release for half an hour.
I'm sometimes not full steering.
Oh, I was so close to jumping off.
Oh, no. Are you using last pet?
I am.
Machine round. Wait, I'm actually almost on the edge.
Just a normal PS5 pet,
Oh, loud is it out. Yeah, I mean, in OGL, Maimant. OTAG are just on another level, though, to be fair. Like, they're just playing way better than all the others. Mainly on the multipliers, though. Like, people are... Like, Avon, for example, he got 89 points after the first four maps, which is, like, really good. It's, like, actually really good. But if you just get solid points all the time and always one of the higher multipliers, you just get so many more points than the others, and that's... And I'm out. That's what's the case for Mime and OTAG. I'm not focusing at all.
The problem is in the Challenger League is that like the point distribution, like the point difference within the top 8 is not that big, right?
Yeah.
So no matter what OTAG and Mime are gonna do in the first four maps, they can't really like escape the rest that far, you know? Like, even if they always get top 2, there's gonna be like at least two or three more people with a good amount of points.
Yeah.
So they have to basically get the high multipliers.
Yep, true. Oh, I wasn't focusing at all. Just get the whole cup.
4-10th. Yeah,
I was actually close. Yeah, Marius is still in. Shorty as well. Yeah, I wasn't focusing at all. Like, that mistake would have never happened otherwise.
I mean, sometimes you're better playing Trackmania if you don't focus.
Yeah, sometimes. Not on tech, for me at least. Alright. Casting time, poke.
My 24 hour performance is back to differ.
Man, I would love to see some 24 hour
some races. Oh god, who yeeted
there
up there?
Announcement. There are announcements about that, yeah. But they are all in French.
Yeah, you can save.
Oh, okay.
What was that? How is that a 0.9? I had the gear down.
How much lower is the safe finish? Where is the safe finish even?
No, you would need to drive the whole turn, like... you would lose like 3 seconds or something. I would guess. Like, no, I don't want to see you going for that. The risky finish is actually easy. Like, it looks difficult, but yeah. 500 bits if Shorty wins, dude. Shorty? Go.
Did you get the money?
Yeah.
That's like the community cup of the day from Turlocks. Like me and Barbas were in the final. Barbas wins. Barbas is like, yeah, I don't want the money. Give it to Shorty.
So you got 10 euro from Trilux himself.
20.
Wait, 20?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's safe because I had a bad start, but I'm not last, not red.
Yeah, it's the F.4. Which is normal ending. It's Barbas behind you, but well, actually, it was getting a bit closer. It's a lot safer if you go for the jump, by the way, Marius.
I'm not ending. Sure. I felt like not confident with jumping.
I mean, if you don't jump, you have the lower jump and you jump further to the level. I think that is tighter then. I think it's not faster, actually. Or at least it's kind of equal, I guess.
I know what Marius means, though. I also go
this
for the
bumping,
lower jump.
This bumping is weird.
Yeah.
Wait, 500 bits to Shorty's channel.
Oh, well then I'm in, obviously.
Wait, do I also get 500?
What is the buy win? I mean, that will not happen, so you can gamble.
That's nice to hear, Yudon. Yeah, I can't wait to mold in Shitfest later. Will be fantastic. Okay, spam is a bit behind, but still close. I currently out.
Lars for molding.
Cool.
Okay, yeah. Safe. Just make it. Kinda lucky that Euro failed, actually. Otherwise, he would've been out.
Yeah, you gotta be lucky. You're not gonna win otherwise.
True. Yeah, I got coached by my girlfriend. Like, during clash time, I was on the toilet and my girlfriend was sending me a message like, why are you risking so much? The others are making so many mistakes. And then I was like risking less, and then I got third on that pool side. It was kind of funny.
My car didn't fully steer in the beginning. What the fuck?
Oh, Virtual is playing. Okay, one guy is a bit behind, but still kind of close for both of you. You have Virtual behind you.
Yeah, I lost like 0.2 at the start.
Okay, it's safe, safe. Virtual touched. Virtual touched. F, virtual out. Influencer out.
My car didn't. I mean, I'm repeating myself.
I'm gonna investigate that.
That was so weird, as if like Action Key 9, but I don't have Action Key 9 binded.
Wait! Okay. Rattenjunge is not driving? Interesting. So one is out. Car doesn't move, nice. Lol.
Like, did he ride that?
Yeah! His car is just over. What? you have like 0.1 currently, Marius. It's Razi. Oh, Massa has a shitty line, but still 0.1. Oui. I mean, nicely calculated. Rattenjunge. You can't even delete.
On the tech map.
Wait, who's Rattenjunge? It's Paxmauer, right?
Yeah.
Is he playing pad or keyboard?
Yes.
I mean, he can type, so it's not just keyboard, I guess. Yeah, interesting. Once again, actually really lucky for you, Marius, because otherwise you would have maybe been out.
Four times in a row on orange.
And you're top 8 on the tech map.
Yeah.
GG.
Finally, I was not really lucky with top 8s lately, so...
Yeah, what do you mean lately?
Especially 2 days ago on the Broken Cup, that was
a... Yeah, 25% okay, boys. And 50% German, if I see it correctly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, yeah, 75% then.
I always have that steering issue at the beginning, no Granadier.
I mean, I can check again. Next round.
No, not. I mean, a different steering issue.
Okay, and you are point 15 behind Marius, full risk.
Where it doesn't smooth steer.
Ah, not enough. Scrappy on orange, actually. That was a close round, though. Who is Chris in Discord?
Could beat that,
Kübel Chris. I mean, in Discord, it's just Chris. Weil in-game he is Kübel Chris.
Papian, danke.
Oh, now it's moves here.
Weird. Now when I'm spectating. What a coincidence. Okay, how many tech players do we have left? Who is Eichel Pomerano again?
It's Gretchen.
Okay, so we only have tech players. So we only have tech players left.
Got second? Or was an armor? Who got second against Eichel?
I don't know.
It's close. Nobody crashed.
Oh, it's cool. So much overspeed.
What a nice turn there.
Oh yeah, close. Yo.
I lost everything in the start. How is that still a point?
Wait, it's crappy out. Weird.
It was just slow.
Yeah, good rounds though.
He got surprised by the goodness of this round.
Mm-hmm. So we actually only have tech players, or people that were tech players at some point. Only one Team GL player left. No challenger. What am I rooting for in challenger? I think Mime and Avon. Boah, Massa. Bruder.
Again, close shot. Nobody crashed. There's a crash now.
Yeah, safe.
Not safe.
By Juicy. I
had a good run though.
Yeah, I think everyone does. It's crazy. Yeah, look, even Ratchet is doing the sub.
Sick.
I want Avon back in Team GL. Yeah, I mean, Avon got kinda scammed. Like, he had to play against Scrappy in the head-to-head, and Scrappy got third in the league. So he lost against him. It was kinda close. Like, Avon would have beaten Riolu and Link quite easily. I mean, they were both out now, but... But I mean, if Avon would not have been out, then I might have not been in. Safe.
It was a crash.
Oh yeah, full safe.
I kinda needed that.
Yeah, not the best side.
I'm just terrible.
It's all in your story.
Yeah.
No.
Welcome to spectating shorty. Like, when I rewatch my old matches, you know, it's just painful. It really is painful.
It's the same for me, to be honest. I feel that. It's nice how all colors are here. Wait, it's 3 versus 1 in terms of countries. It even was 4 versus 1. Is Carl gonna... I mean, wait, Massa did the 64. That's fast.
Yeah, I spectated him the whole round.
I didn't even pay attention. That's pretty...
He wasn't ahead at the start, he was equal only, but the whole mid and then end. Not bad. Massa would deserve it. He's absolutely dominating this. I think he won the seeding as well.
Draw. Tech gamer.
I think nobody hit that corner nicely, because Ratchet was gearing down.
And he didn't lose so much. That's kind of close. We have like point one almost, but it's still really close. Yeah.
That's line that could rip you.
Oh yeah. Whoa! Holy shit!
What
the fuck was that?
Oh my god, that's a 79 winning time even.
Dude, 89 is out, Marius. Wait, you did the triple 89 actually.
What the fuck?
Omega Lul, holy moly.
I hit that turn and I was like, yeah, I'm safe in with that.
What the fuck is that moly video?
89 is this time both safe and out.
Yeah. Like 3 89s. Like 3 players within 7,000. Holy shit. I was really close with the ending.
Oh, that was close for Carl.
Mm. That's close. You all got the gear.
Side.
Yeah.
All 3. Massa had less speed here, bad gear.
It's still close. Like, that equal. Safe, stay safe.
Massa out.
Safe.
Yay!
The Frenchman gonna win.
Come on, 500 bits! That's one döner.
Shorty, nice block through there in the wall. Huh? After the finish.
Thank you.
Good luck. Let's go.
I think Carl is the slowest.
I think I lost it already.
Psh, Marius.
I just had the random thought, how much is 500 bits?
5 euro. He's 07 ahead. Save! Let's go!
Hey, lately people are making mistakes against you.
Yeah. GG.
I put him under pressure with this bits? Point. Oh, I didn't steal. Wait, what? Okay.
PB. What the fuck was that ending? Was that bug?
Yeah, again.
Let's go. It felt like the car didn't fully steer.
500 bits. There you go, Xardo.
Nice.
GG. Well,
and I have 500 viewers exactly at the moment. We got it. Coincidence. Gamer. 500 bits to Shorty, right? To both of us, gaming, right? Ah, 500 bits by Xarge. Thanks, man. Pork.